everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. I am Nuzhat Sana. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GK Today Academy app. You can attend the quizzes on this app for better practice. And after that, you can also read the detailed explanation of the questions you have missed. For regular updates, please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay. Also, our latest initiative is UPSC Prelims Test Series for 2021 and 2022 in GK Today Academy app. So if you are appearing in UPSC prelims, you may consider joining this. So now without wasting any further time, let's get started.
So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 14th of August 2021. Starting with very first question, what is India's rank in the Global Youth Development Index? So in this particular index, India is ranked at 122nd position among 181 countries. And this index measures actually the condition of young people, and it has been released by the Commonwealth Secretariat. Do remember that Singapore was at the top position while Niger came last. So this index ranks countries between 0.00, which is lowest, to 1.00, that is highest. According to the developments in youth education, then their employment, health, equality, inclusion, peace and security, and various political and civic participation. So in total, it looks at 27 indicators, including literacy and voting, to showcase the state of the world's 1.8 billion people who are between the age of 15 to 29 years. Now let's talk about some of the indices quickly. First is World Press Freedom Index 2021. In this, 180 countries were ranked, in which Norway was at the top position and further followed by Finland and Denmark. And India was at 142nd position. Then there is Global Peace Index 2021. And India was at 135th position among 163 countries. The top place was occupied by Iceland. And do remember that Afghanistan is the least peaceful country according to this index. Then there is Global Gender Gap Index, in which India was ranked at 140 among 156 countries. So it is very sad, but India was the third worst performer in South Asia. And again, Iceland topped this index for the very 12th time. Apart from it, India ranked second in share of central bank surplus transfers. Now apart from it, recently Niti Aayog has released third edition of Sustainable Development Index for the year 2020-21. Evaluating the progress of states and union territories with respect to social, economic and environmental parameters. So in this index, Kerala was at the top position and it was followed by Himachal Pradesh and Tamil Nadu with second position. And in terms of union territory, Chandigarh was at top place. And further, it was followed by union territory of Delhi. Do remember that Bihar, Jharkhand and Assam were the worst performers. Then apart from it, as per ICMR's 4th Serology Survey, which was released last month, Madhya Pradesh has the highest COVID-19 seroprevalence and Kerala has the lowest. And Madhya Pradesh was further followed by Rajasthan and Bihar. Fine. So these are some of the important ranks and indices. Question number 2, what amount has been released by the Finance Ministry as post-devolution revenue deficit for the states of India? So recently the Finance Ministry has released its fifth monthly installment of PDRD, that is post-devolution revenue deficit, grant of 9,871 crore rupees to the states on 9th of August. So with the release of this installment, a total amount of 49,300 355 crore rupees has been released to the eligible states as PDRD in the current financial year. And the Commission has also recommended PDRD grants to 17 states during 2021-22. Now do remember that this PDRD is provided to the states of India under Article 275 of the Indian Constitution. And the grants are released as per the recommendations of the 15th Finance Commission to meet the gap in revenue accounts of the states post-devolution. Can you tell me who is the chairman of 15th Finance Commission? Please write in the comments if you know. Then apart from it, under National Edible Oil Mission, Oil Palm, 11,000 crore rupees will be invested by the government to make India self-sufficient in cooking oils to reduce the dependence on imports. Because currently India is totally dependent on imports of edible oil to meet the domestic demand. Then apart from it, also Bharat Electronics Limited has been nominated to extend the procedure of enhancement of digital appeal at National War Memorial, and the construction cost towards establishing this National War Memorial is 176.65 crore rupees. Question number 3. India participated in naval exercise Al-Mohid Al-Hindi 2021 with which country recently? So bearing the testimony to the growing defense ties between India and Saudi Arabia, INS Kochi, which is the flagship destroyer of Indian Western Naval Fleet, arrived at port Al-Jubail in the month of August, and this visit by the ship initiates a new chapter in the bilateral defense ties with the commencement of the harbor phase of first naval exercise between the two countries, that is Al-Mohid Al-Hindi 2021, according to the Indian Embassy in Riyadh. Now apart from it, recently India and UAE have conducted bilateral naval exercise named as Zayed Talwar on 7th of August off the coast of Abu Dhabi. Also recently, India and Russia have conducted a joint military exercise named as Indra 21, and it was held at Volgograd. Then few days back, Indian and French navies have conducted the Varun naval exercise in the Arabian Sea. Then there is exercise Desert Knight 21, and it was in news because it is a bilateral air exercise between Indian Air Force and French Air and Space Force, and it was to be held in Jodhpur, Rajasthan. Then apart from it, there is one more exercise named as Cutlass Express. It was commenced recently on 26th of July, and already we have covered this news. So you have to tell me how many Eastern African countries have participated in this particular exercise. Question number 4. Chief scientist of WHO has urged the nations to prioritize reopening of schools amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Who is the current chief scientist of World Health Organization? So it is Dr. Soumya Swaminathan. And recently she has urged the nations to give priority for reopening of schools in this COVID-19 pandemic, because she said that COVID-19 has indirectly affected the education greatly by shutting down schools globally. So she asked to prioritize school opening while maintaining proper health and hygiene. As we know that in this COVID-19 pandemic, nearly 1.5 billion children were suddenly out of school, and hence their education was affected. In the month of January 2021, Right to Education Forum published its report highlighting that 10 million girls in India could drop out of secondary school due to this COVID-19 pandemic. Talking about right to education, it comes under Article 21A of the Indian Constitution, and it has been added in the Constitution through 86th Amendment Act, and it says that state should provide free and compulsory education for all the students belonging to the age group of 6 to 14 years. Now apart from it, A study by ICMR, that is Indian Council of Medical Research, showed recently that combining two vaccines, that is Covishield and Covaxin, gives better results than two doses of same vaccine. And it has been proved practically as well. Now, WHO was also in news because recently it has launched its first ever report on drowning prevention in the Southeast Asia and Western Pacific regions. So, as per the report, nearly 2/3 of global drowning deaths occur in the Asia Pacific, and drowning is the third leading cause of unintentional injury death worldwide. And in this, low and middle income countries account for nearly 90% of the drowning deaths. Now, apart from it, Soberana 2 is a COVID-19 vaccine conjugate of the country Cuba. Also recently, IISc Bangalore has developed a heat tolerant COVID vaccine so as to maintain the temperature for 1 month at 37 degrees Celsius. And we have seen that Pune based SII will produce the Russian COVID-19 vaccine Sputnik V in India. Question number 5. Recently, the Indian Railways has launched a one-stop solution application to help the passengers. What is the name of this application? So, the Indian Railways has launched an integrated one-stop solution application named as Rail Madad. And for this purpose, the Indian Railways has merged several existing helplines into a single platform for various grievances. So, Rail Madad can be accessed through application, website, SMS, or its helpline number 139, along with social media during the journey for resolution of complaints. And this toll-free number 139 can be used for all kinds of inquiries and making complaints. And the helpline facility is available round the clock in 12 languages. One important thing is, here Madad is an acronym and it stands for Mobile Application for Desired Assistance During Travel. So this is quite important. Now, apart from it, India's lightest metro train is set for Pune Metro, and it is to be sent from the country Italy. Also recently, China has rolled out a 600 km per hour high speed maglev train in Qingdao, which is located in Shandong province of East China. So do remember that it is the fastest available ground vehicle right now. Then apart from it, MSDC, that is Multi-Skill Development Center for Aviation Skilling, has been set up at Chandigarh under CSR scheme, that is Corporate Social Responsibility Scheme, which has been funded by Airports Authority of India. Question number 6. Which bank has partnered with IIFL Home Finance to support and foster the green building ecosystem in the affordable housing sector in India? So first of all, IIFL Home Finance is one of India's leading housing finance company, and recently it has partnered with the Asian Development Bank for technical assistance to support and foster the green building ecosystem in the affordable housing sector in India. So this is ADB's first such private sector agreement in the country. And the cost of the activities to be exercised under this technical assistance agreement is approximately $1 million. And it will enable the activities which address some of the key identified obstacles for building the ecosystem for green certified and affordable housing in India. And IIFL will also contribute an additional amount of $150,000 for supporting these mentioned activities and objectives. Now, apart from it, do remember that Central Bank of India has entered into a strategic partnership with DFL, that is Dhanvarsha Finvest Limited, to offer loans against gold ornaments under priority sector to MSME borrowers at competitive rates. So under this partnership, DFL will originate and process loans against the gold ornaments as per jointly formulated credit parameters and eligibility criteria, and Central Bank of India will take into its book 80% of the gold loans under mutually agreed terms as per the public sector bank's stock exchange filing. Now, apart from it, recently Equitas Small Finance Bank has launched Equitech, which is a fintech accelerator program that aims to startup ecosystem. So this program will basically help fintechs to curate their products and define a go-to-market strategy. And the primary aim of Equitas is to provide startups legal and regulatory support through the venture capitalist and the experts of the bank. And also, to enroll in Equitech, the fintech startup should have at least 2 full-time members along with team members, and it must present an innovative idea. Also, this startup should be incorporated at least 6 years before the date of applying. And already we have seen that recently Karnataka Bank has been empaneled by RBI to act as an agency bank. Why? To facilitate transactions related to government business. Also, RBI has cancelled the license of Goa-based Madgaon Urban Cooperative Bank due to its poor financial condition. Question number 7. Which state or union territory has launched faceless transport services? So recently, Delhi government has launched the faceless transport services, and it will bring all the driving license, registration and services related to permit online. And apart from it, Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal also launched 33 faceless services in a function at IP State Office on 10th of August. So 4 zonal offices will now be closed, and which are they? First is IP State, then Sarai Kale Khan, then Janakpuri and Vasant Vihar. So these 4 zonal offices would be closed. So now 4 MLO offices, that is motor licensing offices, will serve as a facilitation center for public who are not having access to the computers to file their online applications. So these faceless services would comprise like renewal of their driving license, then learning license, then there is transfer of ownership, then duplicate registration certificate, fresh permit from goods and passenger vehicles, then there is international driving permit, or if you have to change the address or anything, okay? So this list comprises of total 33 services. Now apart from it, recently Disaster Management Authority of Delhi has implemented GRAP to effectively manage the COVID-19 pandemic. And GRAP stands for Graded Response Action Plan. And under this, it has actually 4 levels of color-coded alerts: yellow, amber, orange, and red. And red one is the most threatening. Now, apart from it, Delhi at the rate 2047 is also the initiative of Arvind Kejriwal, and it aims to build partnerships with the private sector, CSR initiatives and various other organizations to achieve the vision for Delhi by the year 2047 and make Delhi as a global city in the world so that they can bid for the 2048 Olympics. Question number 8. In association with which organization, Government e-Marketplace has organized the 5th edition of the National Public Procurement Conclave? So the 5th edition of this NPPC was organized by Government e-Marketplace in association with Confederation of Indian Industry, that is CII, and the theme was Technology-Enabled Government Procurement Towards Efficiency, Transparency and Inclusiveness. And the conclave was inaugurated virtually by Minister of State for Commerce and Industry, who is Srimati Anupriya Patel. Now apart from it, Central Board for Indirect Taxes and Customs have launched the Indian Customers Compliance Information Portal, which will provide free access to information about all the custom procedures and regulatory compliance for about 12,000 custom tariff items. Okay. Then apart from it, which two countries have recently organized the third Arctic Science Ministerials Meeting 2021? So these countries were Japan and Iceland. And this was organized for discussing research and cooperation in the Arctic region. And the theme was knowledge for a sustainable Arctic. Then apart from it, India and USA will host the Indo-Pacific Business Forum in the month of October 2021. Question number 9. Which state or union territory has introduced Rajiv Gandhi Award for firms that are excelling in the information technology sector? So the government of Maharashtra has announced about the introduction of this Rajiv Gandhi Award that are excellent in the IT sector in the state. And the award have been named after former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi. So this will be conferred upon institutions and companies for their outstanding performance in the IT sector. On 20th of August, which is the occasion of birth anniversary of late Rajiv Gandhi. And it will be conferred by Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray. And do remember that Maharashtra IT Corporation Limited has also been appointed as the nodal agency to propose the award. Now apart from it, Khel Ratna Award, which is India's highest sport honor, will be now called as Major Dhyanchand Khel Ratna Award. Why? To pay the tribute to hockey legend Dhyanchand. And the title for Dhyanchand's autobiography is Goal. Also, Maharashtra was in news because recently Asha Bhosle has been honored with highest civilian award of Maharashtra, that is called as Maharashtra Bhushan Award. Also, do remember that Indian hydrographer Mr. Vinay Badhwar has won the Alexander Dalrymple Award, which is given by the British government. Now coming to last question, which bank has unveiled Digital Prayas, an application based digital lending platform? So recently SIDBI, that is Small Industries Development Bank of India, that engaged in promotion, financing and development of MSMEs, has unveiled this Digital Prayas to facilitate loans to entrepreneurs from low income groups. So the objective is to sanction loan by the end of the day. And to cater to those from the urban area, SIDBI has tied up with Big Basket to provide loans to its delivery partners for purchase of e-bikes and e-vans. Now apart from it, SIDBI was also in news because SIDBI, in collaboration with FCDO, that is Foreign Commonwealth and Development Office, which belongs to UK, has launched Swawlamban Challenge Fund with an aim to promote entrepreneurship. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide, you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Neenu Zatsana signing off.